Spacing is the positioning of players relative to the ball and other teammates. How a team spaces out determines how a team creates opportunities. And aside from the last 20 or so yards before goal, there's typically no major threat of an immediate scoring chance. This means that for the first 80% of the field, the attacking team is trying to keep its options open to create the best possible scoring opportunity, while the defending team tries to limit the options available. The attacking team wants as much space as possible to create options, and the defending team wants the opposite. When talking about the team in possession of the ball, spacing is used for two main reasons: to exploit space or to open up space for teammates. The player on the ball's first look should be for a teammate up the field in open space, but after that, the player on the ball needs to try to see if they can exploit any space for themselves. That's fairly simple. The more complex situation comes during the majority of what a player has to deal with, moving off the ball. When a player is moving off the ball, they need to consider more details when adjusting their spacing. The first consideration of an off-ball player is if the player on the ball needs help due to pressure from an opponent. If the on-ball player needs help, then the off-ball player should close the space between them to provide an option. Another consideration is whether or not the off-ball player is being marked by an opponent. If they are being marked, then they should not come too close to the on-ball player because they will just be bringing an additional defender to crowd the space. If being marked tightly, it could also be advantageous for the off-ball player to move into an area of the field that provides nothing, taking the marker with them. If the off-ball player is not being marked, then they will be able to exploit space freely. However, the off-ball player should notice that coming too close or at the wrong angle may block the on-ball player's passing lanes to other teammates. One final consideration for the off-ball player is to be aware that being too far away from the ball may mean they are having no impact on the current situation. Sometimes that's intentional, so that they can be involved in the next action or take away a defender from the current action, but other times it just means that they are accomplishing nothing. A way to determine where an off-ball player should be is to think as far away as possible, as close as necessary. Meaning as far away as possible to keep defenders distracted and allow space for teammates, but also close enough to help a pressure teammate and be involved in the action. When talking about a team that doesn't have possession of the ball, the idea is of spacing reverse. Again, it's fairly simple for the player closest to the ball. They just need to close the space of the opponent in possession. It gets more complex when thinking about the spacing of players defending off the ball. An off-ball defender will need to be close to the ball to deny passing options nearby and to provide cover for the on-ball defender in case the on-ball defender gets beat. However, if the off-ball defender comes too close to help, then both defenders may get beat by the same action from the attacking player. Similarly, defenders far away from the ball providing balance need to consider being close enough to provide cover for teammates around them, but not so close that they will get beat by the same movement or run. So when defending, players need to think of their spacing off the ball to be as close as possible, as far away as necessary, meaning as close as possible to provide cover for teammates, but as far away as necessary to deny options away from the ball and not get beat at the same time as a teammate. So there are two main ways for a team to space themselves both in and out of possession: tight and narrow, or wide and spread out. There are, of course, advantages and disadvantages to both. In possession, staying narrow allows for quick short passes as a way to progress through the lines with lots of options. This is particularly useful for teams that try to play fast or on the counter. However, when trying to play through an organized defensive block, this can be difficult. If playing narrowly, an organized defensive block will be able to access all attacking players and prevent any easy passes. One way teams try to prevent this is by ensuring that one attacking player stays in either wing to provide width. This player then acts as an outlet if the organized defense is applying too much pressure. Teams can also prefer to stay more spread out when attacking. Staying spread out allows each player more space when they have the ball because defenders will have to cover all the other options. This can be especially helpful when playing against low blocks because it allows the attacking team to use the whole field, and by doing so, forces the defending team to spread thin and defend the whole field. A disadvantage that comes from this style can be the reliance on every individual player's 1v1 ability. Because of the spacing of teammates, there isn't as much help if a player loses the ball. Therefore, if a team implementing this style of spacing has any players that are poor in 1v1 attacking situations, they have a good chance of conceding dangerous counterattacks. Out of possession, teams have similar options with regards to spacing. They can keep tight and narrow like Simeone's Atletico Madrid, or stay spread out like Bielsa's Leeds United. Again, these have different pros and cons. Staying tight and narrow, typically while using zonal marking, allows a team to not concede space between the lines to the opposition. This means the attacking team will have to create space or go around. However, this type of spacing also means that the defending team can't have access to every part of the pitch because they must shift as a tight unit. So a team using this style of defending would have a difficult time pressing high up the field. On the other end of the spectrum, there are teams who stay spread out. These teams will concede space in between the lines in order to apply pressure to every area of the field. Typically, this means using a more man-oriented marking scheme to be able to effectively prevent any option from becoming available. This, of course, has the disadvantage of allowing defensive weak links to be beat 1v1, similar to a spread-out team in possession. If a defender is beat 1v1, there isn't nearly as much cover and can lead to dangerous situations. So overall, spacing has a large effect on the options available to a team when attacking or defending. How a team spaces themselves out on the pitch will determine the amount of support a player with the ball receives. Combining spacing with structure is what determines the quality of support received, because the structure of a team will say who supports the ball in what situation. This means that a team will have to align both structure and spacing in order to provide the best possible support and the best possible team organization.